Community College.
From the Press Box, Monday mornings at 9.
The Home Stretch, Monday afternoons at 5.
Beyond the Game, Tuesday afternoons at 5 and Friday afternoons at 3.
And Sports Talk, Thursday evenings at 9.
We've got the sports you care about covered on the voice of Nassau Community College.
90.3 WHPC.
WHPC HD, Garden City.
Available on the iHeartRadio app.
Why should you volunteer with Meals on Wheels?
I never thought that 5 minutes could make so much difference in the lives of two people, but it has.
Drop off a warm meal and get more than you expect. Volunteer at AmericaLet'sDoLunch.org. Brought to you by Meals on Wheels America and the Ad Council.
I'm jumping in with my clothes on.
Most party fouls are pretty dumb, but if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Learn more at ultimatepartyfoul.org. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
You're tuned into Long Island's only FM sports voice. This is Sports Talk on 90.3 WHBC.
Hour number two of our radio program here on the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. I guess my lack of skills on the radio board aren't too good today. I meant to play a one-minute promo, but a PSA, but instead I played a 15-second one.
Jeez.
I've been so off on this today. It's been a few weeks since I've filled in for Chris, who is looking through some papers in the back. Tristan was sent out on assignment, so it's just me, Mark Tolkey,
and me, Cameron Bonagora.
Bonagora. Now, how's it pronounced?
It's Bonagora.
No, that, not that. Is it Mepham or Mepham?
It's Mepham.
Okay, it's not an F sound from the
no.
PH. Okay, so why did some people say Mepham?
I don't know. I don't.
So I know you went there.
Yeah, I went to Mepham.
Yeah, I'm over there on the weekend. So
how is it over there?
Interesting, to say the least. Interesting.
What do you mean by interesting? It sounds like something...
I really can't give out the information.
Oh, okay.
But we'll go with that. So hour number two. What's going on with the Yankees right
They're
now?
They're winning right now.
They're winning
6-4.
And how about the Red Sox? They're winning too, 6-4.
Toronto's making a comeback.
It's top of the eighth right now. They got two on with one out, but they got a guy at first and third. So we'll see what happens with that. Look at this. Brewers have the bases loaded at the top of the ninth.
Yeah, I see. With
one out.
Yep.
So maybe Yelich is that bad. Maybe Yelich will hit one out, a grand slam, tie the game. That is a beautiful ballpark, by the way.
Oh, we forgot to talk about the All-Star rosters.
Snell with the big snub.
Yeah, Snell was the biggest snub. I have to agree.
And Nimmo not getting on the final vote?
I
know he's not an All-Star, but at least get him on the final vote.
Yeah.
That would have been interesting. You want to read off the rosters?
Yeah, hold on. Let me just get them up.
Mets, only thing I have DeGrom.
Yeah, Mets have DeGrom. That. For the National League, at catcher, Wilson Wilson Contreras. Contreras from the Cubs. Then we got Freddie Freeman at first. Then Javier Baez at second base. Also from the Cubs. Brandon Crawford at short. Nolan Arenado at third, of course. Nick Markakis, his first All-Star game.
Wow.
He's playing right field. Matt Kemp, who didn't expect to be an All-Star this year, is at left field, and of course, the hometown Bryce Harper in right. At the reserves, we have Yadier Molina. It's going to be Yadier Molina now. I know Buster Posey's injured. He won't make it. J.T. Realmuto is also a backup catcher. Joey Votto, Paul Goldschmidt, Scooter Jeanette, Ozzy Albiez, Trevor Story, Eugenio Suarez, Lorenzo Cain, Christian Yelich, Charlie Blackman, and Jesus Aguilar, who won the final vote in the National League. The pitchers, Max Scherzer, Jacob deGrom, John Lester, I think he's also who's being replaced by Zach Greinke, Aaron Nola, Patrick Corbin, Mike Folkowicz.
Oh, deGrom's not going to play?
No, John Lester.
Okay.
Zach Greinke is replacing him. Miles Moustakas, Josh Hader, Kenley Jansen, Sean Doodle, Brad Hand, Felipe Vasquez. And now on to the American League. Starting at catcher, Mark's own from the Rays, Wilson Ramos.
Who's having a stellar year at catcher.
Yeah, unfortunately he's going to get traded. Jose Abreu is starting at first.
They say people get traded all the time from the Rays, and how many times do they end up getting traded? How many years in a row do they say Archer's going to be traded?
True, good point. Starting at second, of course, is Jose Altuve
usually on the last year of the deal they may do something, but...
Manny Machado's at short. Jose Ramirez at third. Mookie Betts in right. Mike Trout in center field. Aaron Judge in right field. Mookie Betts and Aaron Judge are both right fielders, so I guess one of them will play left. And JT Martinez is the DH. The reserves, Salvador Perez is the catcher. Mitch Moreland at first. It would have been Gleyber Torres, but Jet Lowry's replacing him. Francisco Lindor, also a shortstop. Alex Fredman, third. Michael Brantley, left fielder. George Springer, right. Mitch Haniger, right fielder. Sin Chu Chu in DH. Nelson Cruz, also a DH. Jet Lowry replacing, of course, Torres. And Gene Segura, who won the final vote for the AL. The American League pitchers, Justin Verlander, Corey Kluber, Chris Sale, Luis Severino, Gerrit Cole, Jose Barrios, J.A. Happ, Trevor Bauer, Edwin Diaz, Joe Jimenez, Chris Kimbrell, Aroldis Chapman, and Blake Trinian of the Oakland Athletics.
Now, which pitcher would you take out for Snell?
Happ.
Well, he's going to be a future Yankee, so.
I don't know. We'll see. I don't know. I don't think. What do you feel? Should the MLB and all these All-Star games ever have, like, every team have a representative, or that dumb?
Well, I think they kind of do.
I get it, but I feel like sometimes it leads to huge snubs, and I feel like, hey, I feel like Blake Snell should be in there instead of Happ. But of course, Toronto has to have a representative.
So it makes sense, though. I mean, it's how many man roster is it?
For the All-Star game, I'm not sure.
And who's the coaches? Is the World Series people from last year?
AJ Hinch and Dave Roberts.
Yeah, the Astros won the World Series.
Yeah, AJ Hinch is the manager.
So that'd be the first time. The second time a Astros coach has coached an All-Star game. Remember the 06 All-Star game because the Astros went in 05.
They didn't win.
They made it there.
Oh, yeah, they made it, yeah. Who was the coach of that team? Yeah, look it up.
Let's see. That's a good question. Phil Gardner.
Oh, okay. Only I remember the White Sox coach. It was Ozzie Guillen. He was... Ozzy game was always entertaining.
And it hasn't been a manager since 04. I mean, 07, I'm sorry. Phil Garner. Won a World Series in 79 with the Pirates. He was on that famed 79 Pirates team, which is actually a famous team. So.
Yeah, that's right.
Willie Stargell was the MVP of that one.
Ah, Willie Stargell. My dad loved him.
Your dad's a Yankee fan or a Mets fan?
No, he's a Mets fan, but he looks...
Whoa, how do you have that? How do you,
what?
How did your dad, a Met fan and you're a Yankee fan, how does that happen?
I just didn't want to be a Met fan, so I decided to go to the Yankees.
So, yeah, my dad decided to drop baseball.
No. Because of the Mets?
Yeah.
I can't exactly blame him.
If the Mets are good, he's not going to another team. Oh, so.
You have a caller.
Do you have a caller? Call, you're on Sports Talk.
Oh, you're on Dave Talk. How's that?
Oh, Dave Talk. Dave, why are you not in the studio?
I would ask that question to yourself.
There's always an open chair for you.
Yeah, I know, but I'm never presumptive, and I'm like I said, I'm not going to get into it.
And you're always protecting the newest castle around.
You want the calls from California, I get it.
No, you're always protecting the newest castle around.
Yeah, well, that's like, what can I? But as far as families, as far as split allegiances, my father only insisted on one thing, that we all be Yankee fans. And he said, as far as football, you do what you got to do. And hockey wasn't that popular back then. So, like I said, as long as you have one bonding experience, that's really the most important thing.
Yeah, my family bonded on not watching football on Sundays and watching the Mets instead.
You've got a lawsuit.
Why is that?
I was going to say, watching that. In the
2000s, the Mets were good. 1999, 2000.
Okay. That's a good question, though. With all the, it's a wide question. Is it time to end football?
I actually had many dreams about that before.
Isn't it time for society to end football for all the bad things that happen to the young people and all this stuff? And then when they get older and they get the CTE and they're doing crazy stuff like that.
I think you have a point there. I mean, what would you bring back instead, highlight?
Yeah, without the helmet. Yeah. No, I wish there was a cross study as far as rugby. As far as the CTE and stuff like that, I don't think there's enough speed in rugby. I mean, you can get your bell rung, but I think the fact that these guys are moving at such an increased rate of speed toward each other, and again, it's so, physics has not, my last of my subjects, but think about it. I mean, you got two moving objects coming at each other at 15, 20 miles an hour. Things cannot be good. They really can't. But And then you look at the young lady that got assaulted, and she's saying that somebody, not the smartest person in the world, opened up a second floor window and actually attached the bed sheet. See, it's very hard when you're on the ground to attach a bed sheet to the second floor, but somebody attached it to somebody attached it to the second floor bedpost and put it out the window for these thugs to come in and beat her up.
That's weird.
Yeah, well, it's you're as good as your lawyer. That's all it comes down to. But like I said, these poor guys. I mean, you look at Junior Seau, you look at Duerson, who shot himself in the heart because he wanted the people to study his brain. I mean, it's just a horrible thing. And to what end? I understand Sunday sitting there, waiting for dinner or after dinner and stuff like that. But it's just. And also with the scholarships, going to college, young people might not have the opportunity to pursue a college degree. To that point, I think they should be allowed. But I guess as a society, and like it's not, I'm not going to end it. It's I follow horse racing, which is probably the cruelest sport, but unfortunately, it's a necessary sport because the idea of actually having a horse and paying all that money every year for just basic maintenance and betting it makes no sense unless you're going to ride it. And it's just...
It's a domesticated animal. There's no wild horses.
What's that?
It's a domesticated animal. There's no wild horses.
Well, horse racing is the fleeing instinct of all animals. That's why horses actually have globe eyes, so that when they are eating, they can actually see about 95% of the world around them. Because they're scared to death. This is not anatomy, but horses are scared to death. In the old days, wolves would attack them from underneath, in between the front and back leg, and they were defenseless. And whenever they saw anything, when they were down grazing, they would just take off. And again, those globe eyes, the ones that look all the way around, were the things that saved them. The ones that didn't have it, well, they became lunch.
Yes, that's definitely true.
No, I'm just, it's, it's